elected as councillors, before they can officially take their seat at the table and realise that they're sitting back slightly, they will come forward and take the oath of allegiance and also make a declaration under the local government. So I would ask William and Leslie Joseph Cross, William Edward Hubble, and William Henry Summers to come forward. Three with
of the city of Altona.
Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive them who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
And you be seated, please. At this stage, we have no chairman for this statutory meeting. It would be necessary for the meeting to appoint a chairman for that purpose. Do we have a resolution for this?
I would move to stand by the Councillor Hoskin.
Is there a second up?
Perhaps they want to second.
You've got to be quick, here. We have a second question.
Thank you. I take it as unanimous. If so, I ask you to chair.
Thank you, gentlemen. Fixing of the annual allowance to be paid to councillors for expenses incurred in the carrying out of duties as members of the council. Certainly. Thank you.
I'd like to move the annual allowance to be paid to councillors for expenses incurred in carrying out duties to members of the council for the next 12 months to be $1,500.
Thank you. Do I have a second?
Councillor Crofts has elected to, because of his interest later, but it's up to him.
Second motion, sir.
Thank you. Been moved by Councillor Graham, second Councillor Hubble. Is there any opposition to the motion? If not, declare it carried. Fixing of the Mayor's allowance for the ensuing year.
Yes, I'd like to move this, Chairman, the Mayor's allowance for the ensuing year to be $6,600. I know from experience this won't go terribly far, Mr. Mayor, but I've moved along this line.
Councillor Graham. Any opposition to that motion? If not, declare it carried. Election of Chairman of the Municipality the ensuing year.
Chairman, I have my very much pleasure in moving William Wesley Joseph Cross to elect the Chairman of the Municipality and Mayor of the City of Altona for the year 1984-85.
Are there any further nominations? There being no further nominations, I have much pleasure in declaring Councillor Croft elected as Chairman of the Municipality for the ensuing year 1984-85. Clement, assist Councillor Croft to enter the chamber. Gentlemen, I might just explain, whilst Councillor Crofts and Councillor Clement and Councillor Summers are outside, that on this occasion, Councillor Crofts has requested that Councillor Hubble place the chain of office on Councillor Crofts' shoulders during the particular ceremony. So Councillor Hubble will be performing that ceremony shortly.
He's still got to be there, hasn't he? Right? So, I forget all the formalities, and I just be informal, and I've done this for 70 years. I've never received a rap over the knuckles, and I intend to do the same tonight. Tonight I received a knock on my door. Les Brown came and handed me a big fat envelope, heavy, and I said, "I'm sorry, Les, you've made a mistake." And he looked at me and said, "I'm not a counsellor." He still looked at me. I said, "Take that back, Les," and he stood there, didn't know what to do. I said, "I'm not a counsellor at all tonight." "He take it," he said. You know, as you're all looking up here, I know you're looking at Les, and you're all saying how happy Les is. But I don't believe, in my opinion, that Les is the happiest man in this chamber. My opinion is this, that we have, in Altona, without any shadow of doubt, the best town clerk in Victoria. I also believe that our town clerk believes that he has the best bunch of councillors in Victoria. On the day of the nomination, and when it came 4 o'clock, I was quite sure that Sid rushed out of the back door while no one could see him, rushed home to Elizabeth, said, "Get your hat, we're going out for tea, we're going to celebrate." That be right, Sid, to do that, Elizabeth? In the 10 years of council, it's been well known that I have not accepted the mayor's position. I have got myself to blame for this partly, but I mainly blame Bill Summers. When Bill was first mayor, I remember the end of a month, and in this particular month, it was 31 days, and I went to Bill. Bill may not remember. I said, "How are you going, Bill?" And Bill said, "Great." I said, "Enjoying yourself?" "Yes, great." "Busy?" "Oh yes, busy. I've been out 30 nights out of 31. So I went straight back to Mary. I said, "You forget about never being mayoress." I think I've made it well known over the years that I have three wonderful daughters. 21 years, 23 years, 25 years. My eldest daughter, Lynette, works for American Express, and she holds a very high position there. Melbourne office is the top office for American Express, and last year they were going to go computer-wise, and all the people from the different offices were called to a meeting interstate, and Lynette, being the only girl there, or woman, argued strongly against the computer that they were putting in and argued that it would not work. But of course the men, not men alike, the men went ahead from all the states and said, "We're going ahead." She still argued but came back to Melbourne and said, "It will not work the way they are doing it. They are having an American Express a lot of trouble. And every time, there hardly appears to be a week goes past where a teledex doesn't arrive down into Melbourne to say, send Lynette Hubble so to help sort their problems out." And this happened yesterday, and I think last night I went to bed something like 2:30, this morning up at 6 o'clock, because I'm a parent like you people, you don't let a taxi come and take your daughter out to the airport, you take her out yourself. I'm under the shower, half asleep, and all of a sudden a voice comes from the bedroom and my wife says, "You know, I think I'd be excited to be mayoress." Well, I should have got out there and shown that out for you. You know, I've made it well known, and I really want to come into council and stay 5 years and move on. And then we've got the 7 years, and Bill had a say in the ear, and Leslie, and I'm here for 10. And I said, well, 10's enough for me. But can I say this, that in the 10 years that I've been on this council, or sitting on the council, the chair that Danny's sitting there, that's the chair I've held for 10 years. I have never moved from that seat. And I tell you, I'm taking it back. But in the 10 years that I've been here, and I say this, never ever once have I been able to look either side of myself or look across and point to any councillor and say that man votes for Labour, Liberal, Democrat, you name it. There is no possible way. And you know who I blame that for? Leslie. I call you Les, not Mr. Mayor. Because that's the way he says. I read an article in the paper a couple of days ago, or might have been late last week, where someone wrote in and said, politics not wanted in local government. And the less we see of it. And I praise Les for it, and I will never know how Les could come into a council that was strongly involved with politics and have it to the state that it is now. Also, can I say this, that I've been in that committee room. I've arrived at 5 o'clock at night, I've been there after midnight, and never ever once, never once in 10 years have I heard one argument between the councillors. Again, I blame Les. I blame. And in that 10 years, there was only one thing that happens, and I've heard discussions go on for hours, and as always, what is best for the ratepayers and the citizens of Altona? I again blame Les. Can I say this? That I've been in that chair there for 10 years, I've moved some motions, and you'll all make mistakes when you move motions from time to time. If I've moved one wrong, you can bet that someone will jump up, second the motion, but as he's seconding the motion, he's just moving your motion around to get it in its right way. It's the game, Les, there, always. And I thank you for it, Les, because many times, you know, you hop up and you might say something that's not quite right, but you've just got the knack of doing it. We have here in council, and I may warn you, when I first came into council 10 years ago, I stood in that chair and I talked for half an hour, and I believe Bill Ray Richards was winding me down, so I'm only going a couple more minutes. But we have known here, it's well known, we have what you call a wet cupboard. After our council meetings, it's generally a cup of tea or a cup of coffee. But at our meetings, we do lash out and we're allowed to have a bottle of red wine or a bottle of white wine. Do you imagine when you've got 9 councillors, you've got the executive staff, you've got someone from the Board of Works and someone else, 16, 17, sitting around the table, how far 2 bottles of wine will go? Do you think you can get a second bottle of wine? You know who I blame? The Sound Club. I last this. In my 10 years, I keep repeating and reminding you I've been here 10 years, there's only one thing that I've ever been disappointed about, and I don't think we can blame any of it. Well, we can't. We can't blame any of us, the councillors. We can only blame the government, the way the government saw fit, that some councillors got 15 months and some got 9 months. We've discussed it, and I'm not going to go over that. But what I'm going to say is this. I never believed that any councillor, any mayor, could come to the city and get 9 months and jam it sort of into 12 months. And how you did it, I don't know. He just worked and worked and worked. And I would say this, Graham, you've set a pattern that Les, he'll beat you. He'll beat you, don't worry about it. Les, all the best. All the best. And I know you do a good job.
Maris, would you like to come forward?
Thank you. And echo the words of Councillor Hubble. To you, Councillor Graham Hoskin and Mrs. Betty Hoskin, congratulations on a job well done in the last in your period of office. I'm sure it has been one of great satisfaction to you, Graham, and to you, Betty, because we have had a wonderful two to lead us in this municipality in the last 12 or 9 months. And I have expressed to your last council meeting, Councillor Graham, the council's appreciation, and I'm sure I echo again the appreciation of the city to both you and to Betty for the job well done and with so much dignity and decorum. It wasn't a surprise to us, as I've said before, but really, you've done us proud. Now, my first thank you, ladies and gentlemen, is to the people of the City of Altona. I've said it before, and I'll say it again, that to be returned without having to face an election is a vote of confidence, not only in me personally, and to my colleagues, Councillor Bill and Councillor Ted, but to the whole of the council and the council staff. We make policy, yes, but we have to have the staff behind us, and this Altona City Council is fortunate to have executive officers and staff in general, both indoor and outdoor, to carry out that policy and to make Altona a wonderful place in which to live. It's a wonderful city to serve, and I'm proud to be part of it. I wish to then thank my council colleagues for the honour of electing me once again to this position. Yes, it's a position I now have been elected to for the third term. It's the first time, of course, that anyone has had that privilege, and I am deeply honoured and, I might say, aware of the responsibilities that you have thrust on me. Both June and I, with the support of our family, our friends, and the people of Altona, will endeavour to uphold and maintain the high traditions of this office. The mayor and mayoress of this young city, as Councillor Hubble has said, I believe the city has a tremendous future. It is going places. Thank you, Ted, Councillor Ted Hubble, for the words that you have expressed. This chain of office that Councillor Hubble placed on my shoulders this evening has been placed on the shoulders of past mayors by very eminent people. No less than the Governor, and former Premier, and our very good friend here, Mr. Gordon Stirling, and tonight it was Councillor Hubble. We believe that Councillor Hubble, because he won't accept the mayoralty, because of his own personal commitments, etc., was a fitting person, a fitting councillor to have this honour. And I'm deeply grateful to you, Councillor Hubble, for what you have said and for carrying out that part of the ceremony this evening. The position of mayor does place a great demand on you on one's time and one's energies. Having been through the exercise on previous occasions, I'm aware that it's going to take a lot of effort and a lot of time. But it doesn't worry me a great deal because I know that I have the support of 8 other councillors and their wives. And that makes it a jolly lot easier for me. I think I should at this stage, talking about time, mention to everybody that this evening I am honoured by the presence of my chief for many years now, Dr. John Ritter, his wife, and also one of my right-hand men for many years, Mr. Ian Jackson and his wife. And I might add, ladies and gentlemen, I'm sure Councillor Hoskin and those who have been through this know that you cannot carry out the responsibilities of number one citizen in a municipality without having the support of your chief and of your staff. I do want to place on record my sincere appreciation to you, Dr. John Ritter, and to you, Ian, for all the favours and all the support that you've given me over the years. You might feel a little bit crowded this evening. I hope it's not too crowded, because to limit the numbers to any cure, it was not really fair, and I hope that you'll put up with a little bit of inconvenience and a little bit of bustling. There's a seat for everybody in the hall. But thank you for arriving on time, and I do hope that you have a very pleasant evening with us. Before I close the statutory meeting, I've been asked to give a brief resume of what Council has in view for the ensuing year. It's not always easy to be absolute about this, because our budget estimates have not been approved, and I suppose all I can say is that we will be pursuing projects already in the pipeline. So I think the one thing that's going to happen before long is the railway extension that we've all been pushing very hard for, where we're going to extend the line from Altona to Westona and then on to Laverton and Werribee. And again, I'd like to say publicly that the Minister for Transport, Mr. Stephen Crabb, is number one in the eyes of the people of the citizen and the citizens of Altona. When he was a shadow minister, he made a promise to this council and to the ratepayers that he would see that this railway line was not only restored when they closed it down, but every possibility of having it upgraded and, if necessary, extended. And Mr. Stephen Crabb and the Government of Victoria have seen fit to do this. It will be the first new railway line that has been built for many, many years, probably over 50 years. And I would like to say quite publicly that this council, and I'm sure the citizens of Altona, appreciate it. And I hope, Mr. Stirling, that you might express to him our appreciation also. you may have seen the good publicity that our past mayor has been part of in getting the urban forest established in Altona. Those who are residents here know that we have been for years pursuing a policy of planting trees right throughout our municipality, and I believe it has been an example to others to follow. And I do know that even Mr. Uren in the federal sphere has commented on the way in which the trees have been planted in what was a pretty flat area of Melbourne. And I think you are seeing the benefit of it now, although it does bring some problems also. I mentioned earlier that Altona was a good place to live, and it's true, if you've been reading the papers, that people wishing to come to Altona queue for a week or so and sleep in tents and in caravans to purchase land in Altona. That's not an exaggeration. They have done that, and tomorrow there is an auction for land in Altona, and I'm sure there'll be great competition for all that. So again, I think this reflects on the city of Altona. As mentioned by Councillor Hubbell, I think the needs of Altona people are the number one priority and should be the number one priority of any council. And certainly we will be pursuing that. Altona Meadows is growing and a very desirable place to live. And whether we call it Altona Green or Altona Bay, we are going to see great developments out there. And with our new kindergarten that we hope will be completed in this coming 12 months, I think that we're going to see rather major developments out there in Altona West in the near future. I know our city engineer has got plans already to construct those streets, and they're not going to be the problem streets that unfortunately were designed many, many, many years ago. We've got rather an exciting plan to make that area very acceptable to one and all. We've also agreed for AV Jennings to construct a new 12-court badminton stadium. And I'm sure Mr. Allen Walsh there will be very pleased when that actually gets started up at Paisley Park. So that's going to cost you and I, the ratepayers, some $650,000, which of course is a loan that will be paid back in due course by the Badminton Association. But it will be a regional project, and we will have people from all over the western region of Melbourne coming to play badminton in the Paisley Park complex. We've just recently completed rather a large extension to the civic offices, and after some 20 odd years, this was necessary because they were bursting at the seams. And I believe that now that that is completed, that we'll be looking towards making the civic hall complex, the theatre complex, something that will be a high priority. It's a must, I believe, because when you get into the civic hall tonight, you'll see that it is rather small, and we hope that it will be expanded. Now, you might have read in the newspapers and other comments made by councillors that there will possibly be some changes in our boundaries. It appears, as the government's desire, that there be amalgamations take place. And I only hope and trust that with amalgamations, if they do take place, the government seems to have an idea that we might need to go from 30,000 to a minimum of 50,000 in population. And if that is so, well then of course Altona might take 15 years to reach that, and therefore people might be looking at Altona to expand to, or Altona might be looking towards the area of Brooklyn or the area of Laverton. I don't believe that we want to take over any particular area unless the people of that municipality or that particular part wish to come to us. But if that is to be, this is the Board of Inquiry some few years ago recommended that the Brooklyn area and the Laverton area of Werribee should come to the City of Altona. If that is to be, I think that is the right way that we should be moving, because I think that would be the best move for the City of Altona, and that's what we're here for. Can I just briefly then say that I conclude by pledging the Altona Council, so far as I am able, to constantly improve and guarantee the citizens that we shall strive to make Altona an even better place to live. The Council desires and seeks the support and active interest of all citizens, since public approval signifies wholehearted ratification of its accomplishments to date and leads to hopes of more fruitful and cordial relations in the future. We believe that it is this feeling of democratic cooperation between Council and the private citizen which enables any critical problems to be successfully overcome. And ladies and gentlemen, we do have some problems at times, but we endeavour to cut them off before they become critical. Satisfaction with what has been achieved, an understanding of any difficulties that have to be overcome, and a firm desire on the part of us all to make further improvements to and for our city are the ideal start to further progress in all areas, and they also represent the strength of our democratic council, of which we are all proud. How grand is the prospect which lies before this young city of Altona. Thank you. Privilege, ladies and gentlemen, of making a presentation to the immediate past mayoress, Mrs. Betty Hoskin. As I've said in my introductory remarks, Betty has been a very worthy mayoress of this city, and one in which we have been very proud of, and we are grateful to her and we thank her. And now it's my privilege to place this lovely pendant. Around your neck, Betty. It's a very hard bet, but we'll endeavour to do it. I've got a first go at time. Congratulations.
And their family will now
photographs taken. If you'd all stand, I'm constantly retired. Mr. Sterling, can you also retire, please? As you move through the committee room on your way to the main hall, very as first established, there have only been 7 citizenship awards made. We are fortunate that we do have a number of those people with us tonight. Ex-councillor Cass Yerger, who has been recognised by the government. He has been an untiring worker in the field of support to the migrants who have come to live in our municipality. Mr. Councillor and Mrs. Yerger, please. If we can give them a round of applause. Senior Citizens Club. A gracious lady who has done untiring work for youth in the early days and through the churches and also the hospital. Mrs. Redbray and Mr. Redbray. In Altona, Bill Noonan needs no introduction. To our guests, Bill Noonan, as well as being a jolly good baker, is also a man who has done outstanding service in St John. He has been recognised with very high order. He is now, I think, on the retired list, but he still seems to turn up to all their meetings. And we were there the other night, and there was Bill again. Mr. Noonan and Mrs. Noonan. Last meeting, the council was pleased to bestow on Mr. Albert Rowe the Award of Citizenship, and that award will be presented to him on September the 11th, providing the craftsmen are able to mark him by then. Mr. Rowe came to us some years ago, I forget the exact years, but his very early interest was in safety on the beach. And at that stage, we didn't have a St John Ambulance unit here. So he joined the Spotswood branch, which had the responsibility of patrolling out for shore and giving safe assistance. From there, of course, his work grew. He then became the first superintendent of the Altona unit. Then he took up cadet work and even expanded into the Werribee area to assist them down there. Additional to that, he has done work for the hospital. And then because he was starting to not to show his age, but aware that he was of age, he got activated into a field in the Senior Citizens Club, where he has been an untiring worker, secretary for years, treasurer. He's a fellow who went off because he had a little bit of an attack with the old ticker. But within 12 months, he's back there again. And here we have Mr. Albert Ralph. Mr. Ralph and Mrs. Ralph, it's your pleasure. Support, Altona wouldn't be as good a place as it is. When I'm going to ask you now to move through to the main thing, but the food you'll give me is another report that they do enter, and there will be a presentation of flowers by the grandchildren. The entertainment tonight.
On or off?
Off if you usually had them off.
No, well I don't. I usually have them on, but I think we might have them off because of the glare. Thanks, Raymond.
Reflex.
What are we doing? This is a video. Yeah.
This is a video.
Thanks very much, Neil.
And thanks
very much, Dad.
Thank you, Scott.
Thank you.
Thank you, Paddy.
Thanks very much, mate.
The grandchildren of the mayor and mayoress,
Scott Harris, accompanied by his sisters, Melissa and Rebecca Harris.
What a proud mayor and mayoress this evening.
Rebecca, you're with this, Les.
That's right, man.
Be seated, please.
Will the officers and their wives join in, please? Everybody on the dance floor. Thank you. Thank you.
This evening, we have the manager of the Australian Pops Orchestra, Mr. Kelvin McMillan, accompanied on piano by Mr. Tony Fenlon. Would you give a big hand for the entertainment?
Thank you very much indeed, Ron. Mr. Mayor, Lady Mayoress, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen. Well, it's singularly quite a pleasure and an honour for me to have the opportunity to come down here to Altona tonight. It's quite a long story, and I certainly don't intend talking for very long.
Thank you.
Thank you.